Yes, later than with his girlfriend, Aline Cedrak. We made out of her like a more secretary in the museum and not a big scientist. Hello, my name is Uwe Boll. I'm the director of Alone in the Dark, and here's the director's commentary. Here's now the sex scene coming up, and Usandur's song, the only romantic situation basically in the movie. And a few people said it's out of context, out of order, but on the other hand, we have it before that that she is his girlfriend and he's coming back after 3 months, so to have a little sex should be normal. What is disappointment is for all the fans that Tara Reid is not losing her bra, but this is a typical prude US saying, like the actresses are not willing to play nudity normally, and it's very disappointing, especially for us Europeans and for the US audience, I think. Good that Christina Loken in Blood Rain is full naked compared to Tara Reid here. Look, Tara Reid is going naked to parties and gets in the press with that, but she is not losing her bra in a movie. What is idiotic? Yeah, so. But they're making a big thing out of it, the agents and managers and this kind of stuff. Here we did with that shadow now, we did a little homage to Cabinet of Dr. Caligari. Look here, this is film expressionismus. Here we blowed the door, but the creature is full 3D. And I still don't like how it's jumping now, but the rest of the shot is very good. Like here, it's too much speed, so it falls down in the shaft and comes back here. Out of the shaft. I think it's a very cool shot. Now they're shooting with the new like bullets, and we have the dissolve thing, what looks really cool. And now it's a big action fight scene starting, and the idea was here also, it's also a little homage to the movie Equilibrium with Christian Bale, where you saw only like the light flashes, and I did the same. So we shot it, it was really dark, and I think this is a video game as a movie right now. And this is the only scene basically where we know that Canby has a few special abilities, so he feels a connection to the paranormal. And too, he feels maybe that there is a nest of that creatures inside that mountain, or the gate to hell, or whatever it is. Instinct, basically. And it almost looks like humanity, the humans, are losing against the creatures. And this is the basic idea behind the whole movie, that it's a revenge of nature against the human civilization. So the basic idea is that the lights of civilization are burning everywhere, so there is no space anymore for the creatures in the darkness, hiding in the darkness. And this means also that if the balance of the nature is out of control, people getting wrong, and people getting in stuff get not people, the world gets wrong, the climate gets wrong. And we saw it, for example, with a tsunami in Sri Lanka or Thailand, that the nature is going out of control in a way, and we're having the South and the North Pole melting and problems coming up. So Roland Emmerich's movie Day After Tomorrow is an example for that, what could happen, basically. And we learn it year after year more and more, that the problems are not getting smaller. The problems we're running into are growing up. And it's not about the social problems and employless people or whatever, it's about the nature and the additional, and about the problems we have with the nature and securing the nature and the climate and the balance between day and night, light and darkness, and civilization and nature. This is a very good scene from Stephen Dorff.
They created the whole time. My guys are dying out there for nothing. For fucking nothing! God damn it!
So he gets it here that you shouldn't trust your government. You shouldn't trust the official side of what is in the news, what is in TV, whatever. And I think it's a very good lesson what he's learning right now. They want to stop him, but they cannot stop him. It's already too late. And the knife, what Dorf is now throwing, it's a full CGI knife. So there was nothing. It's very interesting. I think it looks perfect. Of course, I played here against the green screen, but and this shot looks a little fake because they're on that thing, but this is very, very good, I think. And I think our creatures are very cool. I think for Tyra, it was a movie what was unusual for her. She is better in comedies, and it was the first like a horror action movie she did, and physically, she is not the right actress to do this kind of stuff. And she tried her best, and she's a very nice person, and she promoted the movie very good. But it's maybe not the right genre. And Slater, I think he never looked better in a movie, like in Alone in the Dark. He was physically fit, he looks good, he could be a real Indiana Jones, a real hero, and he's a great actor, he's a great voice. A great face. You cannot compare him with any other actor, and this is what I really, really like. And I'm a big Christian Slater fan, and I'm a big Stephen Dorff fan because he's so intense and he's a strong actor, and he can play very good that pissed off guys. So I think he fitted perfectly in the movie. And both are this kind of actors. They didn't made it to the top, but they are very, very talented. And yeah, it's too bad that Alone in the Dark is not a big enough success that we could do a sequel out of it, or that Slater and Dorff are coming back to the A-list positions they deserve to be. Is Slater really not so good like Keanu Reeves? And for example, is Keanu Reeves a great actor, or is he stoic and flat? This is a big question for me, but there's a difference. And who knows who gets hyped in Hollywood and who gets not hyped. The whole ending was my idea, because in the script it was the last big creatures coming up. We have the big end fight and everybody, and then the big creature got killed. And I think I would be better off if I would make this ending, to be honest, for the dumb audience that likes this kind of stuff. And I choose another ending with the empty streets and a more poetic ending, more a David Lynch ending, basically what I thought. And that at one point in the civilization it is over, and you sit there in front of that what you build it, and now it's all senseless because no humans are anymore there. So the city is evacuated and they are totally alone in the big city. So I went that as a route with the ending, and I got punished for it and damaged on IMDb and on wherever people are telling other people that Alone in the Dark is the worst movie as Alien vs. Predator or whatever. And so good luck with Hide and Seek Part 2 or all that other masterpieces compared to Uwe Boll's movies. Far away we hear, maybe some creatures are still there. Everybody is gone. We don't know what it is. It's an open ending. It's not a good ending. It's not a happy end. And maybe our both actors are also dead. So thank you very much. And I hope you like Alone in the Dark, and yeah, see you soon. Bye.